they apply themselves, can be fantastic talent pool for social responsibility initiatives. How many would agree with that? And it's funny, because to us, that's always been a strategy. To corporations, oh, forgive me, I still view it as a PR program. Maybe we can inject some of our talent to help them grow. And finally, number six, cultural promise. Who likes to read cultural promise? Take a pick, please.
Reading with the State Farm Insurance. Our familial style of relating allows us the good fortune of having history on our side. The strongest bonds in business across the entire value chain occur when employees, partners, and distributors alike are treated like family. The treatment is reciprocated and opportunities continue to arise. Our cultural promise is that success comes most to those who are surrounded by people who want to.
So what is our methodology at CHL? Well, in your badge, you've all been given a copy of my book, Earning Serendipity, that teaches the four opportunity mastery skills to propel opportunities and innovation in the workplace. We teach these six natural characteristics to help Hispanic professionals become opportunity mastery experts of the four skills that we teach. Those skills are the ability to see opportunity, sow opportunity, grow, and share opportunity. When we inject these natural characteristics, they provide a very compelling competitive advantage to help us master all four of these skills. If I can connect these natural characteristics to these cover story headlines. And as you know, everything this year has been about transformation. It's been about change. It's been about how do we survive. So take a look at this. Here's January, Harvard Business Review. Reinvent. Well, perhaps our immigrant perspective can put us on the right track. How about this? Power out of the recession. What you don't see here in the top right-hand corner is how to create a strategy for crisis and change. Well, our circular vision can help us do just that. How about leadership in the age of transparency? Well, I think generous purpose and cultural promise can do pretty good in that area. How about this? How to keep star talent. Inject your Latin passion. You will become noticed and propelled to new levels ever experienced. How about this? Managing change. I'm sure by now you can guess what this is. A combination of our immigrant perspective and circular vision. The effective organization. I kind of laugh when I read some of these cover stories. It's looking right at the opportunity. I say all six characteristics because once you utilize them, you master the four opportunity mastery skills that allow you to have a very effective and innovative organization. And then this month, September, we must all think like an entrepreneur. It's our entrepreneurial spirit. What I'm trying to show you is that our natural characteristics are right in front of us every single day. But what these magazines do, and they do a very good job of it, obviously I'm an avid reader, HBR, is they try to make it sound like it's innovative. And for us, it's just been a part of who we naturally are. So, people ask all the time, what is so different about CHL? There's all these organizations, Hispanic organizations that exist. What's so different? Well, I put it in two categories for you, the tangible and the intangibles. Well, the tangibles are this, our clarity of purpose and mission. Two, our approach and style. Our methodology, our curriculum. And then finally, our leadership and corporate experience. You see, I made a decision to convert myself from C-level executive to trainer. I'm not big into titles. Why? Because as I'm training you, I want you to know that I relate to you whether you're alive. executive because I've lived your world. That's how curriculum comes to life. The intangibles. We're cause-based, solution-focused. All we care about is solving the problem, the one I shared with you earlier. Next, we have no political affiliation. For us, it's all about people. It's all about people. Next, we designed an organic growth model. But what does it mean in this case? The center is yours. I just started, and luckily I had a wife that has the patience. But this was designed for you. What do I mean by that? Every day I'm out looking for new Hispanic leadership talent. I want to hear their voice. I want to hear their perspectives. In fact, one of the participants in one of our current programs today, Herman Rodriguez. Hi, Herman. Thank you for joining us. He's here because he's going to be part of this process. He's a voice that wants to share his momentum. So throughout the day, I hope to find new talent because it's about you. It's about building a community of Hispanic executives that can help propel the message and take an active role in the center's development. And then finally, authentic roots. Ladies and gentlemen, like I said before, I have no hidden agendas. I don't have to do this for a living. I chose to do it. I made a promise to my parents, and I made a promise to myself that I would help advance the Hispanic communities in the workplace. So, where do we go from here? You know, this is an interesting question because this is typically a question that's asked at the end of a gathering like this, isn't it? And then what happens? You walk away feeling good, on the way back to the airport or house, still feels good, and Monday comes along, you're back in the workplace, starts to diminish, and a week later, poof, gone. We're going to take a different approach. We're going to take an innovative approach. Next year, we're going to conduct a 10-city tour. I'll read this to you. I will be conducting workshops, roundtable forums, keynotes, and interview key influencers across corporate, academia, nonprofit, and government sectors to address the importance and significance of Hispanic leadership in America. I will visit the 10 most popular Hispanic workplace communities to listen, learn, train, and help accelerate the impact and influence of Hispanic leadership in the workforce. Corporations will be given the opportunity to send their Hispanic professionals to attend CHL's two-day intensive workshop titled Discover Your Hispanic Leadership Impact and Influence. The tour's mission is to create a greater awareness and education towards building a global workplace that will give Hispanic professionals new purpose and opportunities. So, what I'd like to do now is pass them back over to Annette, who has a special guest for you. I'll be joining you here in just a moment. Thank you very much.